Do you know, by reports of Google, why various formulas are used to calculate the value of pi? These are formulas mentioned by Google that are used currently and in history to find the value of pi. And in future too, it's expected to have a different formula if found to be better than present ones. Pi and e are categorized as non-algebraic and transcendental numbers, based on the formula that is required to obtain the value of pi and e. But now, we will also see it actually belongs to higher domain than real number system. Transcendental numbers means it cannot be expressed in simple forms such as direct numbers or fractions or algebraic formula such as golden ratio. It's a super advanced formula than these forms. In simple way, the real number terms in formula are non-terminating, just like numbers in irrational numbers don't terminate. Other formulas such as a is equal to pi r square, c is equal to 2 pi r are relations. It has multiple unknown variables in it and we cannot use it to obtain the value of pi. Now we have these transcendental formulas with infinite terms. And why it is concluded that e and pi belongs to higher domain than real number system is, any formula that is used to express the value of pi or e will have one common entity, and that is zero, or inverse of zero, that is infinity. And surprisingly, operations with zero and infinity are not fully functional in real number system. But same all operations are functional in universal number system. The well-known common operations that are non-functional are categorized as indeterminate forms in real numbers. And note that these are forms and not specific cases. We can create millions, trillions, or infinite cases using any one form by just adding variable n and substituting the value of n with trillion different values. In short, it's not just few forms. There is a whole new locked giant dimension that we are about to explore now. There are many videos on this channel that proves various operations with zero and infinity are limited in real numbers, but fully functional and operational in universal numbers. And here we will use another beautiful and simple way to prove or observe the same that is directly related to pi and e. 1 plus n times 0 is equal to 1 in real numbers. But in universal numbers, 1 plus n times 0 is equal to 1 plus n times 0 itself. This cannot be further reduced. So with such rules, we can express as this in its respective domains. Here, we can't see much difference in these outputs. So let's magnify these numbers by raising the power of equation by infinity. In real numbers, 0 and its magnitude is ignorable in this situation, which means z1 is equal to z2 is equal to z3 is equal to z4 is equal to 1 to the power infinity. And 1 to the power infinity can be any numbers such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 1 million. It can be any number. Hence, 1 to the power infinity is undefined or indeterminate. But in universal numbers, there is a proven relation that 1 plus n times 0 to power infinity is 1 plus 0 to power n times infinity is equal to e to the power n, which means z1 is equal to e to the power 2, z2 is equal to e to the power 3, z3 is equal to e to the power 5, z4 is equal to e to the power 47, and so on. And if this is true, we can observe this in real numbers too using limit concept. So we can replace all zero values with negligible value and calculate in Wolfram to see if values are matching. Let's get the value of e to the power n for given n values. And now, for this value, we get z1 is equal to 7.389905, which we will add in this table. Similarly, we got z2 is equal to 20.08553, which we will add here again. z3 is equal to 148.41315. z4 is equal to 2.58131 into 10 to the power 20. We'll try for some bigger number here. And to get more accuracy, we can increase the depth of 0. And if we see and compare here, these are perfectly matching. So this should be enough to conclude. But let's check about pi 2. One of the basic simplest formula of pi is nested form of root 2. Here the quantity of number 2 inside the root should be same as the number raised to the power 2 that is outside the root. This formula is known as Wiethe's formula. Let's run this on Wolfram. 2 to the power infinity, and then this is the inner roots. But since I can add limited 2's here, I have to add same quantity outside in the power. And it works. Now the problem is, infinity minus 1 is infinity in real number system, which means we can replace infinity with infinity minus 1. And it should not change the formula. Or if we add plus 2 to the infinity, it should not affect the value of infinity nor the output of the formula. But as per universal numbers, we can remove minus 1 from infinity only if we divide both sides by 2. And so solution will be pi by 2. Also, we can add plus 2 here with infinity in this formula only if we multiply both sides by 4. And in this case, the solution will be 4 pi. Let's check in Wolfram. The actual solution is resonating with universal number system. And if we increase the value of infinity here, the solution will still remain same. Only accuracy of pi will increase here. Hence, it's concluded that pi and e belongs to higher number domain than real numbers, that is universal number system, as its formula are involved in operations and numbers that are best functional in universal number system without any limitations. Hope we can get even more advanced and simple formula for pi in this new system.